गाइस, माय नेम इज हिमांशु पांडे एंड आई एम अ थर्ड ईयर अंडर ग्रेजुएट इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एरोस्पेस इंजीनियरिंग। आई विल बी इंटर्निंग एट जेपी मॉर्गन चेज एज अ सॉफ्टवेयर इंजीनियर इन समर 2020। आई एम ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द ओवरऑल प्लेसमेंट कोऑर्डिनेटर्स एट स्टूडेंट प्लेसमेंट ऑफिस IIT कानपुर। सो अबाउट माई जर्नी टू जेपी मॉर्गन, आई स्टार्टेड प्रिपरेशन इन द समर्स ओनली। आई हैडन डन मच कॉम्पिटेटिव प्रोग्रामिंग बिफोर, सो इट वॉज रियली डिफिकल्ट फॉर मी सॉल्विंग द क्वेश्चन इनिशियली। I also hadn't done data structure algorithms course till then. So I started learning the concepts on Geeks for Geeks and I practiced on InterviewBit. I think InterviewBit is a good platform as it covers topic-wise questions and also the level of question is same as what you will expect in a real coding test. In addition to this, I went through MSO 201 slides, only the probability part, and I solved questions from the book 50 Challenging Problems in Probability and a website called Brainstellar. That's pretty much it for my preparation part. So JP Morgan had a relatively easy to medium level coding test. The first question was a variant of finding the maximum sum subarray. The second question was also a variant of standard DP question. JP Morgan had three rounds of interview. In the first round, interviewer asked me to solve a simple question based on divide and conquer. He also asked me if you want to do a project that involved aerospace and machine learning, what it would be and how would you implement it. He also asked me to write some SQL queries as I had mentioned it in my skills. Then he asked me another simple question based on stacks and recursion. In the second round, the interviewer asked me a question on system design, which I had no idea about, but the interviewer helped me a lot in reaching to the correct answer. He also asked me, among all the projects that you have done, in which one you have done something different and how you implemented it. The third round was an HR round. He asked general HR questions. One HR question generally asked to non-CSE students is that why you are choosing software industry given your branch is aerospace. You should frame a really good answer to that and which you could easily defend. Apart from JP Morgan, I gave interview in Edelweiss Finance. The process was quite similar. They asked me 2-3 probability puzzles and asked me questions on regression. On a similar pattern, they asked me, why are you choosing finance industry given your branch is aerospace? In coding domain, companies generally have for software development engineers, quantitative researchers, data science and machine learning. In general, all companies have a coding part and to qualify a test, you need to do well in this part. I would recommend practicing from Geeks for Geeks, as you will get a flavor of all type of questions asked. I would recommend using C++ as the language, as most of the times you will get C, C++ and Java as the option. But unlike C, in C++ you can use the STL library to implement the basic data structures. And use of STL is allowed most of the times, except for one or two companies. In data science, there may be an additional section in which there will be questions from probability statistics, Python and SQL. Similarly, for quant profile, the additional section consists questions from probability puzzles and algebra. Some of the questions for these companies were directly from Brainstellar. But remember, coding part holds most of the weightage and your chances to qualify a test will largely depend upon the performance in the coding part. Companies don't exclusively come for machine learning profiles. They come for software profiles only, but they have a job description mentioning machine learning projects. So having machine learning projects in your resume, courses in ML, knowledge about frameworks, SQL, Python, would definitely give you an edge over other candidates, though it is not mandatory to crack ML interviews. Apart from this, one more thing you should focus on is resume building. I think it is equally important as it gives the recruiter the first impression of who you are. At the same time, you should not put too much stuff on your resume. You should always consult seniors before making a resume and always make them proofread it after completing. I think writing 2-3 projects is more than enough, as it is only to tell that you have hands-on experience and you are passionate about the field that you have applied for. Recruiters generally don't get into the details of these projects. They may ask questions like what you did different in this project or give an account when you got stuck and how you found out the solution. One important thing here is don't fake anything in your resume. the recruiter might ask questions from the skills that you have mentioned, and it puts a really bad impression if you are not able to answer even the basic questions. One more thing, for software profiles, POR don't matter, so you need not to worry if you don't have one. One question that I have got is how a non-CS student can prepare for software profile. So you have to show the interviewer that you have interest in software field, and how you can do that through your projects, courses undertaken, and your competitive programming skills. Initially, you might feel that companies are preferring CS students, but eventually you will also start getting interviews. Be patient, talk to your seniors, and seek their advice. That's all from my side. If you want to talk to me or have some more doubts, you are always welcome.